Hey guys, it's Dani. Today we're gonna talk about orchid fragrances. How do orchids actually smell like? If you're a beginner with orchids and you don't actually have many varieties, it might surprise you to find out that orchids are some of the most fragrant flowering plants that I know of. And while the usual star-bought phalaenopsis don't typically have fragrances, there are a few phalaenopsis who do, and also there are quite a lot of varieties of orchids which have absolutely fantastic fragrances. So I'll go through the categories of fragrance we can encounter with orchids. Let me just start by saying that fragrance is a very, very personal thing. It kind of has to do with the anatomy of each and every one of us. So fragrance will be subjective. It's not always the case that what I detect, you will detect as well. But statistically speaking, chances are that you will detect the same fragrance as the majority of people detect. So with that said, let's start. I will divide the types of fragrances into categories. And the first category is the floral fragrance. It's what you would expect from a flower, let's say. And there are many orchids which resemble other flowers in fragrance. For example, cattleyas. They are well known to have very floral fragrances. And the orchid which inspired this video is this one. This is the Pottinara Burana Beauty. You will have names for all of the orchids that I'm going to show you today somewhere on the screen. This particular orchid smells very, very, very similar to roses, but it's that very nice classical rose scent, which is just sweet and mouthwatering to some extent. For those of you who ever had rose juice or rose jam even, you know what I'm talking about. There is that specific variety of roses, which is the best smelling rose ever, in my opinion. This is what this orchid reminds me of. It has that heavy, sweet, wonderful aroma, which simply makes me think that particular rose. Now, the resemblance with roses is not something super common with cattleyas. In my opinion, cattleyas typically smell like lilies, another very, very fragrant and wonderful flower that we grow in gardens. Cattleya mossiae as a species to me smells like lilies, but there are many, many other cattleyas which smell like that as well. Some of them are no IDs. In my opinion, typically the pink colored ones smell very, very similar to lilies. But the greatest thing with cattleyas and most other orchids is that sometimes the fragrances seem to be combined. So you'll sometimes have an orchid which smells flowery, but also fruity or spicy. We'll get to those categories, but for now, let's stick to the floral category. Another orchid which, in my opinion, smells pretty similar to roses, but not the classical rose, is the Miltoniopsis orchid. One might debate that the fragrance of the Miltoniopsis is quite unique, and I agree, but I am reminded a lot of a particular type of rose which doesn't smell as sweet, but a little bit citrusy. This is how Miltoniopsis typically smell. You can actually find Miltoniopsis which have a slightly sweeter scent, while others might have more of a lemony scent to them. But I believe that for most people, the first impression when they smell a Miltoniopsis is roses, just not the classical rose. As an orchid, Miltoniopsis is not the easiest one to grow in a home, but it's not impossible. I'll try to share with you in the description more links about these orchids, just so you learn more about them. If I have care tutorials, I'll share them as well. But if you love the smell of roses, definitely Miltoniopsis orchids are worth checking out. Another group of orchids which I find smell flowery, simply because they remind me of a different flower, are Brassavolas and Rhyncolalias. Now, these orchids smell during nighttime. Everything that we saw until now and the vast majority of orchids release fragrance during daytime. But there are some orchids who smell only during nighttime. And it just so happens that the fragrance of these orchids reminds me of other nighttime scented plants. The fragrance is very strong, a little soapy, might I add, but I'm putting these orchids into the floral category simply because they smell like most other nighttime fragrant plants. And I think all of these plants actually share pollinators, which are attracted to that type of scent. Hence, the fragrances appear to be very similar. If you love spring flowers, I'm sure you will love Nobly Dendrobiums. There are a few of these dendrobiums which absolutely remind me of hyacinths. The Comet King is the one that comes to mind at this point, and it just so happens that these orchids typically bloom in spring as well. So the fragrances just go with the season. But these dendrobiums are not the only ones that smell like spring flowers to me. Also, we have a vendaceous orchid, the Bangkok Sunset, which I cannot really say that it smells like a plant or another, but it just smells like spring flowers to me. Which of these spring flowers? I don't know. Maybe it's up for you to decide as well. But again, the fragrance of this wonderful looking orchid is very light, subtle, fresh, and definitely springy to me. Vandas can actually smell sweet as well. How many of you love honeysuckle? Well, the Vanda Denisoniana does a very, very great job of reminding me of honeysuckle. The fragrance is very, very sweet, and without having a honeysuckle plant next to me, I really cannot tell the difference between the two fragrances. This Vanda smells during nighttime, by the way. It's one of the very few Vandas which release fragrance during nighttime, but it's wonderful and absolutely worth it. Now, since there are so many orchids and obviously there isn't enough space in my grow space, in my house, in my garden for all of these orchids, I of course will be missing some. I'm sure there are orchids which smell like other flowers out there as well. So if you do know other orchids which I didn't mention, share them with us in the comments down below, because I'm sure that everyone wants to know what orchids have what type of fragrance. With that said though, let's end the chapter of floral fragrances and move on to fruity fragrances. And you will find a lot of orchids smelling like all sorts of fruit. First, let's start with citrus fruits, which can be oranges, lemons, all of these fruits which are slightly sour but definitely mouth-watering. Cattleyas are known to have either floral fragrances, either citrusy fragrances. And the one I'm showing you right now is a hybrid. You have the name on the screen. It's not a registered hybrid as far as I know, but definitely I saw it for sale in flower shops and garden centers. This orchid has a wonderful fruity fragrance. It's mouth-watering. I cannot say it smells flowery because when I detect this fragrance, I instantly think about citrus juice and I'm in the mood to go and get myself some oranges and make some juice. But she is not the only one with this fragrance. The Cattleya Purple Cascade, which is another very popular orchid, smells very citrusy as well. There is a difference between scents, yes, and some of these orchids can actually combine a floral fragrance with a fruity fragrance, but in my opinion, many Cattleyas actually do have a very citrusy fragrance. If you're a big fan of Phalaenopsis orchids, well, you're in luck. There are some Phalaenopsis which smell very mouth-watering and very, very fruity. First, it's the Phalaenopsis bellina, which is a species. Now, this is one of the most popular Phalaenopsis species in the whole world because of its fragrance. It's mouth-watering and very strong. But this orchid doesn't actually produce a lot of flowers. The flowers are not very big, certainly not as the orchids that we find in flower shops. If you want something similar to that, I would suggest looking into the Phalaenopsis Leodoro, which is a hybrid of the bellina, looks more like a typical flower shop, and sometimes you can actually find it in the flower shop, and smells very similar to the bellina. Again, mouth-watering, a little citrusy in my opinion, tutti frutti might I add, but everything a little sour. Think Skittles. Both of these orchids are very, very popular among growers, so there is a high chance you will love the fragrance of these orchids. Let's look at some Vandas now. Recently we had the Aretis Hulaceana in bloom, which smells very lemony. Now, when I say lemon, I don't say pure sourness. No, it's more of a sweet type of lemon, but definitely you wouldn't think peaches, let's say, if you smell it. You would think, oh, lemon pie. Very delicious lemon pie, might I add. And this orchid releases one of the strongest perfumes in my collection, actually. Definitely worth having if you like this type of fragrance. One of my favorite orchids is the Oncidopsis nelieiler. Now, this orchid is the only one that I know of which smells like lemons. And I'm not saying sweet lemons or lemon pie. No, very stark lemons. For this reason, not everybody likes the fragrance of this orchid, but I find it super unique and again, a little bit mouth-watering. But I can see how this particular one might be love it or hate it, so be careful with this one. But to me, it's pure lemons and the orchid looks lovely. But if lemons and citrus are not your thing, then maybe some forest fruit. Yes, we do have an orchid which smells like raspberry. And not only one actually, quite a few of them. The Dendrobium perishi, but also the Dendrobium anosmum are known to smell like raspberries. And the vast majority of people absolutely adore the fragrance. So if you're into that, you might want to check these two Dendrobiums out. They're very similar between them. The only difference is the perishi tends to remain smaller, has smaller flowers as well, and the anosmum has bigger flowers and grows longer canes, about a meter or more long. But hey, there are sweet fruit in this world as well, aren't they? Well, we have sweet fruit smelling orchids as well. Take for example the Maxillaria tenofolia. The vast majority of people actually detect a coconut fragrance from this orchid. I actually detect more of a peach, maybe even pineapple fragrance from this orchid. It's definitely much sweeter than everything that I just described until now, but since I don't belong at the majority, chances are that you will detect a coconut fragrance from this orchid. It is lovely nonetheless, I absolutely adore the fragrance, no matter how you would describe it, but definitely this type of fragrance is sweeter, even if still fruity, than everything we just saw until now. I don't think there are many orchids which smell like sweet fruit. I think most orchids, at least in my collection, at least the ones available on the market, they go into the citrus category actually. Which is not a bad thing, but I would be interested in knowing more orchids which smelled like sweet fruit. And since we're talking about sweetness, let's get into the third major category of fragrances, at least for me, the sweet fragrances. We have a lot of orchids that smell very sugary, very sweet, and even more than that. So first, let's start with one of the most iconic orchids you can have, the Oncidium Cherry Baby. To many people, this orchid actually smells like chocolate. To me personally, it smells like milk chocolate, like Kinder eggs. It's absolutely delightful. I have never ever smelled something like that. Well, except for chocolate, of course. Now, to some people, this will smell like vanilla. Again, it's a very subjective thing, but both fragrances are absolutely amazing. The Oncidium Cherry Baby doesn't excel when it comes to the sheer beauty of flowers, but the fragrance actually compensates for everything. The only downside is that this orchid is rather large and produces pretty unruly flower spikes. Display-wise, it might not be the best-looking orchid, but fear not, we have another hybrid which smells absolutely identical, and this is the Oncidium Heaven Sent Redolence. Now, this orchid has a much prettier flower in my opinion. We have multiple colors on the flower, and also the flower spikes don't tend to be as long and as spindly. They tend to stay more compact. As I was saying, the fragrance is identical, intensity is identical, so if you prefer this type of flower, then of course, check this one out. I'm telling you, the fragrance is exactly one-to-one chocolate or vanilla, one of the two. You cannot say that this orchid smells like apples, absolutely not. Beware though, the fragrance is pretty strong and very sweet. If you have an issue with sweet fragrances, I'm not sure that you would love this orchid. Other very sweet smelling Oncidiums are the Oncidium Sorowanum, which is a parent of the Cherry Baby, and also a parent of the Oncidium Twinkle. Both the Sorowanum and the Twinkle, in my opinion, have identical fragrances. They're not chocolatey, but they're very sweet. Very heavy, very sugary. It's like a syrup, in my opinion. To me, it's not as wonderful as the Cherry Baby, but it's definitely pretty strong and wonderful in its own way. The Twinkle Oncidiums remain quite tiny, and they produce very tiny flowers, but in great number. So they're very popular for this reason. Coupled with the fragrance, of course, and hey presto, yet another super iconic orchid that I would definitely keep an eye out for. Now, if you like sweet fragrances, but you're not into the very heavy, sugary ones, might I suggest the Oncidopsis Bartley Schwarz? The fragrance is very subtle, but it's sweet and slightly artificial, like sweet candy, but not very powerful. I really like the fragrance of this orchid, and I think it's just perfect for those of you who do have issues with sweet fragrances, but you would still like to have a little breeze of sweetness every now and then. I think the Bartley Schwarz is one of the best candidates for you. Bonus, it's a really easy Oncidium to take care of. Don't be scared that it has Miltoniopsis in its parentage. It inherited more from its Oncidium side. Another orchid which people say smells like chocolate, it's the Encyclia cordigera. Now the fragrance is not very heavy and sweet. Maybe it smells more like dark chocolate, maybe more like sweet cocoa to me. Definitely an amazing fragrance, I absolutely love it, but it's absolutely different from the one of the Sherry Baby. So you can see people refer to both of these orchids as having chocolate fragrances, but they're very, very different. Definitely want to check out because it's an easy grower. The fragrance is now very, very mild though, but I don't think it's as heavy and as sweet as the other ones. And if chocolate isn't your thing, then maybe honey is. The Dendrobium Berryota is one of the easiest orchids you can grow. It blooms once a year with beautiful purple flowers and it smells, in my opinion, like honey. Some people would say that it smells like sweet jasmine, so maybe it's a mixture of honey and jasmine, of sweet and floral. It's up to you to decide because, again, fragrance is very personal. To me, it smells more like honey than anything else, hence why I placed it in this category. And I've heard there are other dendrobiums which smell like that as well. They're not the same type of dendrobiums as the pendant ones, as the Parisii, the ones that smell like raspberry. No, they're different. They come from Australia, most of them. So really, it's up to you to check out, but I know for a fact there are other dendrobiums which smell like honey. So these are the three main categories I would typically put fragrant orchids, but there are some orchids which just have the most unexpected fragrance ever. And one of them is the spicy category. In this section, we are not dealing with floral or sweet fragrances, but something a little more obscure than that. First of all, woody fragrances. The one that I'm showing you right now is the beautiful Shelob Okika. It is in full bloom, and luckily enough, it doesn't smell like pepper, but it does have a slight woody, slight artificial sweet type of fragrance. She's not the only one. I met a lot of Brassia hybrids with this type of fragrance. But there are some hybrids of the Brassia which have a very peppery fragrance. It's not my favorite, but definitely it's unique. And these are the Bellaras, or currently known as Alisara orchids. And the varieties vary. They all have one thing in common. They smell spicy. They smell like pepper. Now, I know some people absolutely adore the fragrance because it is unique. As I was saying, it's not my favorite, but definitely it's not something super powerful with these orchids that it will kick you out of the house. It's not like you spilled pepper all over the floor. That would not be nice. It's definitely noticeable when you smell the orchid. And for a flower that beautiful, I don't think I would imagine it smells like pepper. Would you? Another type of fragrance, which I'm just going to include in spicy because it's just weird, is exactly that, the weird fragrance category. And I think I have the best candidate for it, the Cygnotus Wine Delight. This orchid, I cannot tell you how it smells like. When I smell it, I think about a pharmacy, but in the good way, if that makes sense. It has a pretty spicy fragrance, but not a spice you would necessarily put in food. It's just something unusual. I don't know about you guys, but I kind of like the smell of fruit-flavored vitamins. You know it's artificial. You can detect there's a medicine involved there. But it tries to actually be something else. Well, that's how this orchid smells like. I love it. It's one of the most unique fragrances I have ever detected. My boyfriend kind of hates it. I know there are people who cannot stand it and people who absolutely adore it. And the last category of fragrances, hold on tight. It's the bad fragrances. And it's not just me being subjective here. It's 100% across the board, everyone agreeing, foul-smelling orchids. And most iconic are the Bulbophyllums. Now, the ones I'm showing you on the screen don't smell bad. They're actually not very fragrant. They smell maybe like grass or something. Not the most pleasant things in the world, but not repulsive. However, there are Bulbophyllum orchids out there which try to imitate something that a fly might be interested in, and I'm not gonna go into the details, you can imagine. And no, I'm not talking about poop, I'm talking about other things flies like. They smell like something passed away for a long time. The reason why these orchids smell so bad is that their main pollinator are actually flies, and that's what flies are attracted to. It is super, super interesting, but having one of these orchids in your home might not be a pleasant experience. I heard that hybridizers are trying to eliminate this foul-smelling gene from them and obtain hybrids which preserve a lot of their parents' traits, visual traits, but none of the fragrance, which would be wonderful for us. But there you go, sometimes nature doesn't really work the way we work. In this video, I tried to stay away from orchids that I find pretty bad smelling, but other people find good smelling, because it's just very, very personal. So do keep in mind that some orchids will just smell different to you. Some of them might smell pretty bad. And it doesn't mean there's something wrong with how you smell, it just means you're different. And you also have different memories associated perhaps with these fragrances, and that's fine. It's good for us to be different. But there you have it, I hope you enjoyed this video list, let's put it like that. And you'll keep in mind these orchids if you do like fragrances. If you have the chance, do give them a sniff. And you know the drill, like or dislike this video below, subscribe to my channel for regular orchid videos, tutorials, Q&As and other fun orchid subjects. And if you'd like to support the channel, do consider visiting the merch store down below. And with that said, I'll see you guys next time. Bye!